Last Sunday evening, a fire burnt the home of one of our valued colleagues, Khumutso Modise from the EWN team. The fire burnt it really to the ground. It was a disastrous inferno, and obviously, as you'd imagine, it's turned their lives upside down, leaving the family with pretty much nothing. Thankfully, everyone was able to escape without any major injuries. Her mom is in recovery after she was admitted, I think, for smoke inhalation to hospital. And a fundraising initiative has now been set up to help the family get back on their feet. Khumutso Modise spoke to my colleague John Perlman on the afternoon drive earlier this week. I want you to have a listen to how she describes her family home, obviously all the items that are gone that had sentimental value for her and her family. Have a listen.
For a house like that, of such great sentimental value, all of my, both of my siblings were born there, raised there. My grandmother lived there with us before she passed.
Right.
You know, and she, you know, her room is the room that caught a light first, you know. It's been a few years since she passed. And we really, that room did really, you know, hold a lot of sentimental value for us. You know, her chest of drawers that she used, that she loved so much, her bed, you know. I would still walk into that room just to, you know, kind of feel like, you know, to remember her for a bit, you know. And that's all gone now.
Yeah.
You know, we've also lost, as you rightfully say, a lot of the letters that we've had. I know that
right.
My parents were really big in terms of documenting when we were born,
sure.
You know, writing some of the progress that we've made from the first time we walked to the first words we said. And that is all gone right now. So it's a different feeling. You can replace a microwave and an oven, but you can't replace that those priceless gifts that we had.
Indeed, you can't, can you? All right, we're joined now by Eyewitness News news editor in Johannesburg, Lebogang Tate, on the line. Lebogang, I mean, Khumutso Modise is a dear colleague of ours. She's been with the Eyewitness News team for a number of years now. This was really, really a shocking story, was it not?
It really was. Bongani, good morning. Thank you so much also for reaching out to us for this update. Khumutso's family is really thankful for this generosity from everyone really who rallied around them when they needed this help the most, especially in the immediate aftermath. Like you say, it was really, really tragic. You know, no one can ever anticipate anything of this magnitude happening, a tragedy of this magnitude, and
yeah.
People really did show her massive support and kindness. So
we thought it's important for us to highlight because, as you'll know, the Eyewitness News team really at times see the best, but quite often the worst of what unfolds around us. It is them who normally report on stories like this, and when it happens to one of our own, we just felt that we needed to highlight this issue and see if we can get any help. Already, as I say, there's a fundraising initiative that is underway. You talk of generosity, but obviously it's a long road ahead, is it not?
It is indeed. So today is day 4, Bongani, since the fundraising page went live. The response has truly been great, and we appreciate every cent. We set up this portal for Khumutso and her mom as a way to centralize donations, monetary donations, that is, because from there, everything is better coordinated. And as of this morning, we have raised 37,600 rand.
Oh, wow.
Towards the 100,000 rand goal that we set. And like I said, this is truly phenomenal, and we're truly grateful for all of the contributions. It doesn't matter how small, it really does make a huge difference. And if I may, I just take you through how, you know, you can help.
Of course.
There are various ways in which you can do that and access the crowdfunding page. You can just go to www.quicket.co.za, that's quicket.co.za, and search support for Khumutso, and that page will come up. 702, obviously, and Eyewitness News have also posted articles on their website. We can access this link to the crowdfunding page. So there's that. There's also a quick response or QR code. You simply scan the barcode from your phone It will take you straight to the phone. Even if you Google support for Khumotso, you should be able to find the page. So there are those various options available. All right.
Well, keep an eye on that. But really, we appreciate the generosity of so many people around 702 Land, our listeners, people who obviously appreciate the work that Eyewitness News does as a team. And when one of our members is in trouble, people are reaching out to help. So you can go to www.quicket. That's Quicket, quicket.co.za, and you can search there for Khumotso Modise. Lebohang Tate, we appreciate your time. Eyewitness News news editor in Johannesburg.
Current events, developing stories,
tough questions,
your voice making a difference.
This is Breakfast with Bongani Bingwa.